With artificial intelligence sneaking its way into every aspect of our lives now, from graphic arts to film and television and even audio, is Steinberg's powerhouse audio editor Cubase finally starting to use some of these powerful artificial intelligence tools inside of its own application? Let's dive in and find out. Hey guys, it's Steve from Feather Light Studio, and today we're working inside of Steinberg's powerhouse audio editing application, Cubase. Now, with so many plugins like the new Focusrite Fast System and the iZotope's Ozone plugins using artificial intelligence in their tool set to vastly expand what those plugins are capable of, we want to find out, is Cubase on the verge of using artificial intelligence in its own application, and specifically the newest plugins that are just now coming out? So a perfect example of that is a new plugin called Colors Free. This is a mind-blowing and incredibly creative plugin that takes the traditional idea of a soft synth and kind of turns it on its ear with some incredibly intricate routing and control options that really don't come in very many synths, especially of this type. So we're going to start off here in Cubase with a really basic project open up, and it just includes a version of Halion Sonic, and we have Colors Free loaded up and ready to work with. And in its default, the area here in these little rows here, these little blocks down here, these are the patches. If you click through each one of these, you can see that it's calling up a different patch, which is shown on this window here. And each one of these is a completely different configuration. And the windows above it, these guys, are showing all the available modulations that are taking place inside that voice itself. The basic layout is pretty straightforward. We have patches, we have what's called an easel, which shows us the different layers in each one of the voices. We can have a total of 4 layers for each one of the voices. And then we have a master control section that allows even more control over that itself. So if we start here in the patches part, this patch is called It's a New Day. Patches have some kind of modulation on the mod wheel itself that can be used. So this can go from kind of an innocent sort of happy sound to dark. Just by changing some parameters with just the mod wheel by itself. So if we move on to the next patch here, this is called Vintage Strings. And each one of these instruments have a huge range of different configurations and routing options. And we can get to those simply by hitting the easel window here. And the easel window will show us everything that's in each one of the voices. So this current voice uses 3 different layers or 3 different kind of voices. And each one of the voices has its own set of controls. If we solo each one of the voices with this little indicator here, we can hear the voice oscillator layer a lot clearer. So from here, we can pan the voice to the left or the right. We can change it up or down in pitches. Then we have some controls under here that even increase that amount of control. We have the ability to instantly assign the volume of the layer to our mod wheel controller. So if we just click that little button that lights up, now we can control the volume with our mod lever. This is a great way of getting instant control over a voice simply by assigning it to a hardware controller. We also have some additional controllers. We have a ton of different ARP settings. So from here, we can create an ARP sound and have it play based on the tempo of our project. We can change the length of how long the note lasts, from really tight legato, and so on. Lots of different arpeggiation controller options here simply by hitting the play button here. In addition, we have a ton of different filter options as well. We can change the filtering of the voice. Put a low cut filter on it from here as well. And then the last option here is the attack settings of the voice itself. And slow it way down so it ramps up. On the second voices, we have slightly different controls. So we have the same volume control here, but in addition here, now instead of the arpeggiation feature, we have modulation choices instead. And our modulations can run in real time, just like the arpeggiations can. So those modulation features change the amount. And you'll notice as the modulation is changing, it gives us this little window indicator above the voice to let us know that that actually has modulation going on. And that can be changed, of course. We can change the tempo of that modulation. So as we go up or down, modulation gets faster and slower. And the modulation can be turned on or off simply by hitting the play button. Same thing on the third voice here as well. We have those same modulation options and the same choices down here. And on our fourth voice, this particular patch only has three voices, but our fourth voice, we can click the plus button and we can add a bunch of different noise attributes to this. And some of these are really cool. We have everything from just standard white noise to a bunch of different variations of it. If we solo these, we can hear it a little better. Kind of a modulated sweep. We have a tape loop. We have a kind of a vinyl simulation. And then equalet. And all of these have those same controls. We can control it with the mod wheel here. We can change and add modulation for that particular sound. We have those same filter controls as well, in addition to the attack settings. And then we have the same panning and octave options just for the noise sections by itself. So this can really add some unique and interesting kind of lo-fi textures and stuff to your existing voices simply by adding one of those modules. We'll add some modulation. Bring the volume down a little bit. Then, in addition to the individual voice sections that we can use, up to the four different layers, we have a master section as well. And the master section allows us to quickly change dramatically the character of whatever the four voices are. So we have things like decay, how quickly the overall voice will decay. Right now, this is pretty legato. So we control all the layers at one time by changing the decay parameters of the characteristics of each one of the layers. We have a drive control. The drive currently controls warmth. We can change the modulation throw of the actual knob, meaning this is how much or how little the modulation control, if enabled, which is this little button right here, is going to affect that particular voice. This is a really handy feature if you don't want the modulation lever to throw the entire effect all the way from 0 to 100%. If you only want the fully raised modulation lever to raise it only halfway, now you can see this has changed here. It's only raising it by that amount. So this is a really quick way to determine how much the mod lever, if assigned to that particular parameter, is going to affect the total amount of that. So currently this is our drive is basically controlling warmth at the moment. It can control bit depth, so we can reduce the bit depth if we don't want to control drive here. Same thing with the filter control. The filter control gives us the ability to control the filter of the overall voice. And that can be instantly assigned to our mod wheel as well. So right now it's not controlling it, but if we click that, it is. And if we come down and look at the mod wheel controls of it, same thing applies here on our edit window. If we click that little E, the little E opens up the edit window for each one of these categories. So drive, filter, chorus, Reverb, and Main all have an edit window that we can change the parameters of. So in our filter parameter, we can change the resonance of it here. We can change how much the mod wheel is going to affect that. And in addition, if we click and drag anywhere in our mod wheel window, let's bring this point all the way down. You'll notice that we can have different kinds of curves as well. They can be logarithmic, for example. We can have it start off really slow for the throw of our mod wheel and then get quick towards the end. We can even double click and add control points to make those changes even more. So these can be a lot more dramatic depending on how we raise and lower our mod window. We could have some pretty sophisticated mod wheel changes here. But up until now, we've really just walked through all the different presets, and there aren't a ton to choose from. So at first, it seems like maybe it's a little bit limiting until you realize that the ability to change all these voices on the fly is kind of overwhelming at first because there's so many different options. But the real beauty of this comes into play if we go back to Easel and we see this little randomize button down here. This opens up a whole new world of possibilities because we're not just stepping through patches here. In this particular case, we're letting the program itself, we're letting Colors Free decide for us by creating a completely new patch from scratch. These are its own decisions and its own choices and its own routing and its own possibilities and voices and combinations of stuff, all being served up to you simply by hitting the voice one time and coming up with some really bizarre results. So each time you hit that randomized voice, Colors Free is coming up with its own artificially generated concept of what it thinks would be creatively interesting. And it's a huge range of things to try because it's constantly randomizing or coming up with new and interesting creative choices, even if you just use them as a starting point. So whether or not this actually is artificial intelligence or not, I'll leave that up to you to decide, but you got to admit that it's a pretty unique way to create interesting and creative ideas, and especially ones that maybe you wouldn't have chosen yourself. So once you get all of that done and you come up with something that you really like and you want to keep that, we can use the ability to save our presets here just like we would with any other preset inside of Halley and Sonic. We simply come up to our presets window and we choose the save preset option here. And from here, we can call it whatever we want. But the real power of this comes into play when you realize if you go to the program button up here, this shows you currently all the things that are active inside of the Halley and Sonic environment. So currently we have one layer loaded of Colors Free, but you'll notice we can have up to four total layers of that. So we could literally load another layer of Colors Free here. We could take the exact same synth pad starting point and we could load it up onto its own other complete layer. So in addition to having layer one here as our Colors Free option, we could go to the next layer. And this could be a completely different patch of just Colors Free. So think of all of those routing possibilities and options with just one instance of Colors Free, and then multiply that times four. I mean, it's a mind-blowing amount of stuff. So there's a quick look at Steinberg's brand new Halleyan-hosted instrument, Colors Free. And it's from one of its creative partners, Cinematique Instruments. And as you can see, it really pushes the line between VST instruments that require you to build all your sounds and patches completely from scratch by yourself, and that new incredibly powerful randomize button that can build complete and intricate patches, multi-layer patches and everything, completely from scratch automatically for you. So this greatly expands your overall creative potential and possibilities in your productions and your mixes. So check out Steinberg's brand new colors-free instrument hosted inside Halion Sonic 7. Hey, thanks for hanging out with me today. If you learned something or if this was helpful in any way, please hit the subscription and notification bells. It really does help keep the channel going. It helps me make more videos like this. Stay safe, be creative, add something creative to the world. It could really use it. Take care. We'll catch you guys in the next video.